Welcome to the part 3 and week 8. Local maximum and local minimum, and absolute maximum and absolute minimum. As you have seen in the preview, there is a lecture note and the lab in this web address. The derivative can be used to determine whether a function increases or decreases based on the sign of slope at a point or on a given interval. Okay, there might be a changing point of the slope. We call it a critical point. The derivative of a function will be zero at a critical point. The second derivative can be used to determine whether a given function has a local maximum or a minimum value at a critical point. Okay. Using the second derivative, we can check a function has the absolute maximum or minimum on a given interval. Okay. In this week, we will cover these three sections: application of derivatives and applications of second derivative, and local maximum and minimum, and absolute maximum and minimum. We start from the applications of derivative. Let f be a function defined on an interval I, then for any two distinct points x1 and x2 in I, if f of x1 is always less than f of x2 whenever x1 is less than x2, then we say f is increasing. If it satisfies the opposite condition, then we call f is decreasing on I. Okay. We will see it from the figure. Here, if like this, if x1 is less than x2, then f of x1 is always less than f of x2, then this function is increasing. And if x1 is less than x2, but f of x1 is bigger than f of x2 on any point on this interval, then we call this function is decreasing. So we see this is an increasing function and this is a decreasing function. Those are the mathematical expression of those two functions of such a character. If f prime of x is positive at all points in the interval a and b, then f increases on the interval ab. If f prime of x is less than 0 at all points in the interval ab, then f decreases on closed interval ab. For example, f prime of c is bigger than 0, then the slope of the tangent line to f at x is equal to c is positive. This slope is positive like this. So it's an increasing function. Then at certain point on the interval, the slope, tangent line, the slope of the tangent line is positive. If this is a decreasing function, then the slope of a tangent line is negative at that point. Okay. Let f of x is equal to x cubed minus 6x squared plus 9x plus 1, and find all increasing and decreasing intervals. This is a graph of a function. Then we will see this is increasing here, but decreasing from here to there, and it increases from here to all the way. So we can do this with this SAGE code. You can practice this code just by copying this and go here to practice. First, we define f of x, like what we have. Then find the first derivative of f of x. Derivative of f of x with respect to x. Then plot the function from minus 1 to 4. Then we will have this graph. And then find the first derivative. Print it. First derivative. First derivative. And then solve. This first derivative is bigger than 0. This will give us the interval where f prime of x is bigger than 0. So f prime of x can be found as this. And if you solve this equation, then we will have x is less than 1 and x is bigger than 3, which gives us this. As you see here, this is the interval of f of x increases. So from minus infinity to 1, it increases. From 3 to all the way, it increases. And from 1 to 3, this function decreases. Okay, so the interval increases are from minus infinity to 1 and 3 to infinity. Interval of decrease is from 1 to 3, as you see. So if you can draw the graph, you can easily figure out, then this code can be used to find the exact the value of your need. Second, applications of the second derivative. Convex functions play an important role in mathematics. They are essential in the study of optimization problems. A curve y is equal to f of x is said to be concave up or concave down, like this. Concave. Convex down. This is convex down. And if x, f of x lies above the tangent line at this point C, f of C, for all x near C. If the function is above this tangent line, then we call this is concave down, like convex down. Okay. Similarly, the curve is said to be concave down or convex up, like this. At this point, if x, f of x lie below this tangent line, then we call this is concave down or convex up. So in this case, we could have a local maximum here. In this case, we have a local minimum here. The second derivative indicates when the function is convex up or convex down. Convex down, convex up. When a continuous function f is differentiable on an open interval I containing the c and f double prime of c does exist, then the following holds. If f double prime of c is bigger than 0, then f is concave down, like this. If the second derivative of the function at this point is positive, like this, slope is positive, and the second derivative value at x is equal to c is positive, then f is convex down at this point c and f of c here. And if f double prime of c is less than 0, like this, then f is convex up at C, f of c. So convexity can be determined by the second derivative of function. Since f double prime is a derivative of the first derivative of f, so f double prime of c is bigger than 0, then f prime increases near x is equal to c. Since f prime means the slope of the tangent line, the slope of the tangent line is increasing. Hence, f is convex down at c f of c. Similarly, yeah, we can say the following statement here. As you see here, the slope of the first derivative of f is changing here. But it's getting, the slope is getting, here is a negative, but negative is getting smaller and smaller, and it's turning out to the positive, and the slope is getting bigger and bigger. So change of the slope is increasing on this interval. Okay, it gives us the concave down, which gives us the local minimum. Okay, like this. Here, the slope is increasing, which gives us concave down, which gives us the local minimum. Here, the slope is changing from here to here. The change of slope is getting smaller and smaller. Here was a positive, and here zero and negative. It's been changing. This, if the second derivative of f of x is decreasing from negative, from positive to negative, then we will have concave up here, which gives us the local maximum. So find the interval where this function is concave up or down. Let f of x is given like this. Then find out. Define f of x first, and then find the first derivative of f with respect to x, and find the second derivative of x with respect to x. Here, what we did is we differentiated the first derivative of x with respect to x, which gives us the second order derivative of f. Then we plot the function f of x on this interval, minus d to 5. Then we have this graph here. So we have local maximum here and local minimum here. How we can find this point? What we have to do is solve the second derivative. Second derivative is bigger than 0. With respect to x. Solve this. This gives us the interval which f double prime of x is positive. That comes out this, which means if x is bigger than 1, then the slope of the first derivative of f is increasing. So from 1 to here, we have second derivative is positive. So this gives, is this from the negative to 0 to positive, which gives us this shape, and which gives us the local minimum here. This is concave down, and we're going to have local minimum, and x is equal to a certain point here. Okay, so we found the interval. So it is concave upward when x is less than 1, and concave downward when x is bigger than 1. Here, concave upward here and concave downward here. Additionally, 1 and 1/3 is the inflection point, and this point about here, we're going to have an inflection point where f double prime of x is equal to 0. In this graph, this function is concave, convex down after the inflection point, 1 and 1/3. From here to here, it's a concave, convex down, which gives us the local minimum. So last section 8.3 deals with the minimum and maximum. If f of x is continuous on a closed interval AB, then there exists the absolute maximum and absolute minimum of f of x in this interval. To find this, we must know the notion of local maximum and local minimum. The function f has a local maximum, respectively a local minimum, f of c at x is equal to c if f of x is less than or equal to f of c for all x in a neighborhood of x equal to c, like here, local maximum. F of c is here, and f of x near there is less than f of c. So which gives us the local maximum. So local maximum or local minimum is called the extreme value. So these points, this and this are all extreme point. It's called the extreme point. And the point at which a function has a local maximum or local minimum is called the critical point. We call this and this point called the critical point. Mm-hmm. Okay, as you see here, this is a local minimum, this is a local maximum, this is a local minimum, this is a local maximum. This point gives us a local minimum, and this point gives us a local minimum, this one. Mm-hmm. Okay. And at the end point here, we find the value of the function, then compare all those values, then this is the largest. So this gives us, this point gives us the absolute maximum of the function on this interval, and this is the smallest one. So this is the absolute minimum of the function on this whole interval. Mm-hmm. Okay, here one letter is a okay, I fixed it. Okay, from this observation, we see that all possible candidates to be an extreme point must be x is equal to c, where f prime of c is equal to 0, or f prime of c does not exist. As you see here, f prime of c is 0, here f prime of c is 0, here f prime of c does not exist, and here f prime of c does not exist, because left limit and right limit are different. And here f prime of c is 0, and here f prime of c does not exist. So for those local maximum or minimum point, we have the first derivative of c is 0 or does not exist. We call those points critical point, critical point, critical point, and critical point, and critical point, and critical point here. So for each critical point, the following condition holds: Fermat's theorem. This theorem is called the interior extremum theorem or Fermat's theorem for extrema. Okay, first, if f of x has an extreme value at x is equal to c, then f prime of c is equal to 0, or f prime of c does not exist. This is very important to find the maximum or minimum. First, find out all critical points of a given function. Okay, since f is a polynomial function, there is no point where f is not differentiable. So all critical points are 0 and 1. Okay, we can find the critical point of this easily after finding the first derivative of this. And these critical points are the solution of the equation f prime of x, which is minus 6x times x minus 1. So 0 and 1 are critical points. Define f of x and the first derivative can be found and solved. The first derivative is equal to 0 with respect to x, then we have 1 and my and 0 is the critical point. So we have critical point 1 and 0 that we found by using the above code. And also we can solve it by hand too. Now we can determine all local maxima and local minima. When a function f has f prime and f double prime at c in the domain with f prime of c is equal to 0, then if f double prime of c is less than 0, then we have f of c is a local maximum. If f double prime of c is bigger than 0, then f of c is a local minimum. Because in this case, we have a concave, convex down. Convex down. It's a local minimum. Okay, the following figure shows a function has a local maximum or a local minimum at a critical point. Here, as you see, here f prime of c is 0 and f double prime of c is negative, which means the slope of the tangent line is decreasing from big positive and small positive and 0 and small negative and big negatives. So slope of the tangent line has been changing, it's decreasing, so which gives us convex up and it gives us a local maximum. And here, the graph is like this in blue and tangent lines are red. And the slope of the tangent line was big negative here, but small negatives. And then it becomes 0 at the critical point and changing it to the positive sign and moves up to the big slope. So the f double prime of c is increasing from negative to positive. Okay. And 0 at the critical point. Okay. So the absolute maximum and absolute minimum of a continuous function f in a closed interval can be obtained by comparing the function values at all critical points and the function value at both end and interval. So if I check the values at all critical points, when you have, and check the value of the function at the end to end point, then compare all those values, then we will find the absolute maximum and absolute minimum on the interval. This is the theorem, a problem. Then this is the algorithm. In order to find the absolute maximum or minimum of a given function, then find all the critical points of f on the interval, and then compare function values at all critical points and all endpoints, both endpoints. Example 4, find all local maximum and local minimum of f. F of x is defined here on this interval, minus 2, 6. Then define a function and find the first derivative, and solve, and then find the second derivative. Then solve the first derivative equal to 0 with respect to x, then it gives us two critical points, 3 and minus 1. And then find the second derivative at these two points, 3 and minus 1. Then print out those values, then check the function value at the end point f of minus 2 and end point 6, so f of 6. So we have f of minus 2 and f of 6 and the value of the function at the critical point f of minus 1 and f of 3. Compare these four values, then that gives us these four values. Among here, minus 5 is the smallest. So this is a these two are local. These two are local. Maximum and minimum. These two are local maximum and minimum from the critical point, and this is the value of the functions at to end point. Then compare these four values, which gives us what the largest is 22. This is the absolute maximum of the function on the interval. This minus 5 is the absolute minimum of the function on the interval, on this interval. Mm-hmm. Okay, mm-hmm. Absolute minimum is minus 5, and absolute maximum is 22. Mm-hmm. Okay, mm-hmm. That's what we found. Mm-hmm. Here is open problem 2, which is a homework for you to do. Find the sum twice differential function in any of your book and use the above code to find the local maximum and local minimum and the absolute maximum and absolute minimum of that function. Okay, then Fermat's theorem for extrema. The optimal solution x star should satisfy f prime of x star is equal to 0. So therefore, we solve an equation f prime of x is equal to 0 and determine which critical points gives us an optimal solution. Mm-hmm. Okay. However, if this function is complicated, then it's not easy to find the ultimate critical point, which is the solution of f prime of x is equal to 0. If f prime of x is a complex equation, then we cannot find the solution of this by hand. In that case, we can find them by using numerical method. The gradient descent method is one of the most popular numerical optimization methods for solving this type of problems. We will study the gradient descent method in the next class. Here is the references. Yeah. In this, in the calculus here, mm-hmm. in this calculus book, chapter application of differentiation, yeah, you will see all the details of the information, and also in here in this web address, yeah, you will see all the problems, exercise problems, and solution with the code as well. Mm-hmm. Okay. And there are a bunch of problems and solutions that you can handle. Mm-hmm. Okay, I think that's the end of the main lecture of this week. If you have any question, then yeah, feel free to ask it in Q&A. We will leave you in the lab, and you will have a practice before we close up this part of lecture. Thank you for your attention.